Let us discuss different experiments which shows electromagnetic induction. Here you can see there is a circular coil connected with a galvanometer. And say if a magnet is brought close to the coil, here we can see that the magnetic lines from the magnet passing through the coil are increasing. So when the magnet comes closer to the coil, you can see a current induces, which we can see in the deflection of galvanometer. And if the magnet is brought back here, you can see that the direction is changed and the galvanometer shows deflection in opposite direction. And continuously back and forth, the magnet starts oscillating. Here you can see the direction of current in galvanometer continuously changes, or we can say due to this type of motion between magnet, a relative motion between magnet and the coil, an alternating current is induced in the circuit. This is because of the EMF induced in the coil. Similar to this, here you can see another experiment. There is a uniform magnetic field in which there is a rectangular loop placed, and a part of loop is outside the magnetic field at which a galvanometer is connected in the circuit. And here you can see if the loop is pulled out of the magnetic field, here you can see that the total flux which is passing through the loop is decreasing, and due to which we can see deflection is there in galvanometer, and here we can see it is because of an EMF induced due to change in flux through the loop. Similarly, if the loop is pushed into the magnetic field, the flux increases and the direction of deflection in galvanometer is opposite. That means an opposite EMF is induced. Similar to this, here you can see another experiment in which we can see there are two rails P and Q. These are smooth rails, and to these rails a bulb and a galvanometer is connected, and the rails are in a uniform magnetic field. Here we can see a uniform magnetic field in the direction into the plane of this paper is applied, and a rod AB is also placed on it. Say if we start moving this rod AB, here we can see the rod will start cutting the magnetic flux of this magnetic field. Or you can say the loop which is formed by the circuit, on the left side of the rod, the total magnetic flux associated with it is increasing due to the motion of rod, because of which an EMF is induced, and here you can see the bulb is glowing and the galvanometer is showing a deflection. If the rod is stopped, you can see the bulb stops glowing and the galvanometer deflection comes to zero because no change in flux takes place here. If the rod is displaced in the opposite direction, you can see again bulb glows, but the direction of deflection and galvanometer is opposite. So these all experiments are giving us the idea about how electromagnetic induction takes place. And the basic phenomena is whenever there is a relative motion between magnetic field and a conductor, whether a field is moving or the conductor is moving in such a way that total magnetic flux associated with the loop or conductor changes, an EMF is induced which can cause an induced current in the circuit if the circuit is closed.